shows the total amount invested by any, which I will read here. Formerly a financial advisor. What is Oblivious investing? And more importantly, why would you want to do it? Some investors check their portfolio values online every day. Other investors feel that it's necessary to read or watch the financial news each morning to see how the market performed the day before. Still others, obsessing endlessly over piles of data, constantly move their money around between various stocks or mutual funds in an effort to outperform the market. What do all of these activities have in common? Their attempts to exert control over something that we simply cannot control, the stock market. They arise from an abundance of worry and a lack of confidence. They're a complete waste of time. Oblivious investing sits at the opposite end of the spectrum. Oblivious investing is about creating an investment plan and sticking with it, staying, or at least acting, oblivious to the daily whims of the financial markets. Confidence from history. We've all read in countless disclaimers that past performance is not an indicator of future results. However, what better method do we have for learning about successful investment strategies than to see what has and hasn't worked over the last century? By carefully studying history, we learn several important lessons. Over short periods of time, stock returns are extremely volatile and unpredictable. Over longer periods of time, however, this volatility decreases substantially. Over a long enough period of time, stocks, as a group, have nearly always outperformed bonds. Inflation, almost unnoticeable over a period of just a few years, has a very significant impact over an investor's lifetime. Confident in the above facts, oblivious investors follow a simple two-part strategy. Number one, invest heavily in stocks via diversified low-cost mutual funds. Number two, hold on to those funds for decades at a time, ignoring all the short-term fluctuations of the market. It isn't exciting. It isn't original. It is effective. Blocking out the noise. Oblivious investors aren't unique because of their investment strategy. After all, multitudes of investors say they follow a buy and hold strategy with diversified mutual funds. Sadly, however, investors today hold mutual fund shares for barely 3 years at a time. Not exactly a long-term buy-and-hold strategy, is it? What defines oblivious investors is their ability to stick with their strategy over a period of decades even, or especially when the market's volatility seems most frightening. Why are oblivious investors able to stick with their strategy without worrying? Because they know how to distinguish what's important from what isn't. They know that there are a handful of supremely important facts covered on page 2, and they know that everything else is just noise. This year's hottest funds? It's just noise. What the market did this week? Also noise. What the market did this year? Still noise. 10 must-buy stocks? Noise. Interest rates up or down? Noise. How to predict bull and bear markets? Noise. Why would you want to be an oblivious investor? Oblivious investors know that most of what they read and hear about the market is, in fact, irrelevant to them. They know that there are just a few important facts to remember. Through oblivious investing, that is, through focusing on what really matters while ignoring everything else, you'll be able to, number one, spend less time managing your investments. Number two, worry less about your money. And three, enjoy better results. Part one, the plan. Chapter one, too much information. Shannon stared at her monitor. Overwhelmed with information, she was feeling a mixture of confusion and frustration. Earlier this year, Shannon had finished paying off her student loans. Since then, she had taken the part of her paychecks that had previously gone toward paying off the loans, and she had put the money into a savings account. In November, with $3,000 in her savings account, Shannon decided it was time to start investing. She opened an IRA with a brokerage firm online, and she funded the account with her $3,000. Unfortunately, she now had to figure out what to do with the money. It was proving to be more difficult than she'd expected. There seemed to be an unlimited number of choices. Stocks, bonds, mutual funds, index funds, exchange-traded funds, CDs, and more. Shannon read and read, but she was quickly coming to the conclusion that even if she could figure out which type of investment she wanted, she still wouldn't really know which particular investment she should use. After all, most of the categories had hundreds of choices. She decided to call her Uncle Toby. Toby answered on the first ring. Hello? Hey, Toby, it's Shannon. Hi, Shannon, what's up? Hey, do you mind if I swing by for lunch? I just opened up an IRA with a brokerage firm online. I set the account up just fine, and I deposited some money. But now I have to figure out what to invest it in, and I thought you might be able to answer some questions. Yeah, you bet. Come on over. I'll make us some sandwiches with the leftover turkey from Thanksgiving. Cool. See you in a few minutes. Shannon put on her jacket, grabbed a notebook, and walked out the door. Her apartment was just a few blocks away from Toby's house, so she decided to walk. As they sat down with their sandwiches, Toby said to Shannon, I'm certainly happy to help in any way I can, but I'm curious, why'd you call me? Why not your mom or dad? Shannon explained, I heard you mention at Thanksgiving that you're on track to be able to retire in a few years. You're only 50 though, right? 52, actually, answered Toby. Oh, well, retiring at 55 is still pretty darn good. The funny thing is, I never knew you were really into investing. I'm not, replied Toby. In fact, I'm more or less unaware of what the stock market does from day to day. And I almost never look at my investment accounts, except when I get my quarterly statements. Then how have you managed to do so well? What's your strategy? I call it oblivious investing. Shannon laughed. Oblivious investing, huh? That doesn't exactly sound like a good thing. No, I bet it doesn't, Toby agreed. Let me explain, though. Oblivious investing is not about being uninformed. It's about creating an intelligent investment plan and then consciously choosing to ignore anything that could trick you into giving up on it. I see. So what's this intelligent investment plan I should use? Shannon asked. That's the easy part, and we'll get into it in just a minute, Toby said. But first, let me warn you. Plenty of people have perfectly good investment strategies, but they still fail to build any substantial wealth. How do they do that? Shannon asked. By failing to actually stick with their own strategies. That's how, Toby replied. Oh, so it's kind of like trying to lose weight. Everybody knows how to do it. What's hard is actually keeping up with a diet and workout plan long enough for it to work. Exactly. Over the years, a lot of things will come up that could cause you to doubt your plan. If you're able to ignore those things, you'll succeed. If, however, you can't ignore them, it's going to be much harder to reach your financial goals. Chapter 1. Too much information. Over the years, many things could cause you to doubt your plan. Ignore those things, stick with the plan, and you will succeed. Chapter 2. What are your goals? How much will they cost? What are the relevant time frames? Financial goals? Shannon asked. Yes, goals. After all, it's just common sense that before we can talk about how to invest, we need to know why you're investing. Why is it that you're trying to accumulate money? Asked Toby. Well, I'd like to buy a house sometime soon, so I'm working on saving money for a down payment. And of course, I'll need to save for retirement as well, Shannon replied. Good. Now the more concrete you can get in terms of what it is that motivates you, the better. It will make you more likely to stick with the necessary investment plan, said Toby. Shannon groaned. I'm not exactly the type for introspective exercises. Oh, that's okay. I suppose we really only need to know two things about each of your goals. First, we need to know what it will cost, and second, we need to know your time frame for meeting that goal. What will it cost? So let's start with your first goal. You said you wanted to buy a house. How much do you think that's going to cost? I've been doing a little research, and I think I want to have about $20,000 saved up for the down payment, Shannon answered. And for your retirement savings, Toby asked, how much are you going to need saved in order to retire? Good question. I don't even know where to start with that one. All right, let me just give you the rule of thumb that I'm using. If your investments are your only source of income in retirement, you'll want to have saved 20 to 25 times your annual expenses. Of course, it's important to remember to adjust your current annual expenses upward to account for inflation between now and the time you retire. Geez, Shannon said, even without adjusting for inflation, I'm going to need about $1 million. How the heck am I going to save that much money? Well, Shannon, I think you'll be pleasantly surprised by what a dollar can turn into if you allow it enough time to grow. What is the relevant time frame? Yeah, you had mentioned something about time frames for each goal. Do we just need to know how many years I have in order to save the money? Shannon asked. Close, but not exactly. Let's start with your first goal. How long do you have until you want to make the down payment on a home? Shannon answered. I was thinking that I'd like to buy a house by... Thank you so much for joining me today, and congratulations on unlocking the first captivating 10 minutes of this exclusive audiobook experience. Hopefully, it's made you hungry enough to come on over to my Patreon community for more thrilling chapters and premium content. Subscription cost is very low, just a cup of coffee. For just that minimal contribution, you'll have access to the entire audiobook, plus a treasure trove of exciting perks. Your support not only fuels this creative endeavor, but also ensures a continuous flow of immersive stories. So don't miss out on the magic. Become a patron today and let the financial adventure unfold. So come on over to Audio Money Honey's Patreon page and elevate your listening experience.